God is the creator of evil. This may be contrary to what is taught in the churches, but this is declared in Isaiah 45:7. I form the light and created darkness. I make peace and created evil. I, the Lord Yahweh, do all these things. Christianism's myth says that God created a goody-good angel that was the highest of the heavenly host, and that one day, for some unknown reason, this perfectly created angel rebelled against God and exalted himself to the position of God. These church kikes even give this angel a name and call him Lucifer. And according to their perversion, it is from Lucifer that evil came into existence. The name Lucifer is used only once in the Bible, and that is in Isaiah 14:12, and it is not the name for Satan, the devil, but is the name given to the king of Babylon, as stated in verse 4, and to his wicked kingdom Babylon, as stated in verse 22. Lucifer is from the Hebrew word heylel and means bright, shining. This is just another example where church doxology is built upon the technique of jerking a word out of context and giving it a twisted interpretation. This evil perversion is an outright attack upon the absolute sovereignty of God by the Christian church, which has become the synagogue of Satan. The very thing that bears the name of Jesus Christ is Antichrist. It is the beast spoken of in Revelation 13:11, which looked like a lamb, but spoke like a dragon. Revelation 12:9 says that the dragon is that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. There is no Lucifer name given here, therefore it cannot be used synonymously for dragon, serpent, devil, or Satan. Only these four can be used interchangeably. The Bible always defines its own terms, but the churchy synagogue of Satan bearing the name Christian applies its own corrupt meaning to everything in order to propagate its heresy called the gospel of salvation, which is the new social gospel. In one fell swoop, it does away with the law of God, his plan, and sovereignty. The essence of their corrupt theology is that God is an inept creator whose perfect creation is now spinning out of control. Evil runs rampant as Lucifer's unabated rebellion is taking over the world. Poor old God. All he ever wanted was for people to be good. But now, he is rendered helpless by Lucifer's evil and man's freedom of choice. Because of this situation, Christianism gains its legitimacy as the official organization designated by God to do that which he is helpless to accomplish on his own. Man, full of all manner of fleshly ego, believes that he can choose to do good, accept Jesus, get saved, get others to do the same, and eventually go to heaven, while Lucifer drags the majority of the world into the fires of an everlasting hell. It is a most humbling experience to realize that God is in control of all things, past, present, and future, and that Lucifer's rebellion and man's free will are only illusions of the blind taught to the blind. John 6:44 will be a shocker for those acceptors of Christ, soul savers, and goers to heaven. Jesus plainly states, "No man can come to me except the Father which has sent me draw him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Then in verse 65, "And he said, Therefore said I unto you, that no man can come unto me except it were given unto him of my Father." Jesus said it, And if it offends you, then just twist and squirm on the hook of God's word. It is time to cast off the Lucifer rebellion myth and to apply the correct name, Satan, the devil, to what is going on in accordance with God's plan. In John 8:44, Jesus tells the Jews, "You are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him." Here it is clearly stated that the devil was a murderer from the beginning. Satan, the devil, has always been the way God created him. The Apostle Paul says, "Had not the potter power over the clay of the same lump to make one vessel unto honor and another unto dishonor?" What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction? Romans 9:21-22. Also in the first and second chapters of Job, there are two accounts given when Satan has to present himself before God. He is no rebellious, antagonistic enemy, but must give an account of his activities and must obey God pertaining all his future actions. Satan, the devil, was made perfect for the work that God created him to perform. For those that light is dawning, the next step begins with the question, why did God create evil in Satan, the devil, the serpent, the dragon? But no one goes any higher until it is understood that everything was created by Yahweh God according to his plan and will fulfill his purpose. There is no evolution going on in God's creation. Good doesn't become evil, nor evil good. Wheat doesn't become tares, nor tares wheat. No, tares do not change themselves into wheat by deciding to be wheat. Nothing can change what God has made in the way he made it, but the whole creation in heaven and in earth will fulfill all his will. Glory be to Yahweh God, the author and finisher of all things. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.